Welcome to the President's Diary, where we take a look at His Excellency Dr. Mohamed Irfan Ali's week of activities. His Excellency started his week by launching the $200 million Shadehouse project at the Ghana School of Agriculture cotton field along the Essequibo coast.
Highlighting the tremendous value that the Essequibo region holds for Guyana, President Ali said it is not only rich in natural resources, but also play a critical role in national food production.
If you look at what we're trying to create here, for lettuce, for example, we'll be able to add to our national production close to 40,000 pounds head of lettuce to national production. If you look at that, at the current market prices, you're talking about revenue of close to $10 million from lettuce alone in this facility.
The project will see the construction of a hydroponic shade house to advance Guyana's vision of supplying the CARICOM region with healthy, high-quality food, mainly fresh vegetables. It will employ 200 youths from the region and will enable farmers to target high-value crops.
Later that evening, President Ali joined thousands of Guyanese at the National Stadium for the Patriotic Night of Reflection, where he assured citizens that he will stand with his country in the face of challenges.
I want every Guyanese to know, regardless of the circumstances, how difficult it is, how easy it is, how burdensome it is, how dangerous it is, you will never see me away from you. I will be with you at the front, by your side, every single time, every single moment. You can be assured of that. Do not worry about this.
Importantly, he asserted that no amount of propaganda or rhetoric stemming from Venezuela will stir Guyana's unshakable resolve that the Essequibo region belongs to us.
No amount of rhetoric, fear, or terror coming from our neighbor would shake our resolve in the fact, in the truth, that Essequibo belongs to Guyana and our borders were settled full and finally in 1899.
During an interview on Monday with the BBC on the Guyana-Venezuela border controversy, President Ali reaffirmed his stance on the matter, which supports the dignity of all people and leads to the continuation of peace in the region.
I'm concerned that Venezuela can indeed follow up their rhetoric and their narrative and act in a reckless manner. And this is concerning because already we have a dangerous situation in Venezuela where the people are suffering as a result of the type of governance, where the respect for the rule of law, where democracy and all these things are threatened.
On Monday, President Irfan Ali conducted a walkabout in Eccles Housing Scheme, East Bank Demerara.
The focus of his visit was to address critical concerns with particular emphasis on the issue of drainage and road infrastructure. The president assured residents of immediate action.
I'm concerned especially with the old Eccles. The drainage situation I think is ridiculous to say the least. So we have to deal with it. From Friday we're going to deal with the entire drainage situation here. The roads, the roads is a consequence of the drains too because of the flooding and so on. So the drains, the roads, that seems to be the priority in the area. Same with the, in the new Eccles, a lot of work has been done in cleaning the drains, but there's still, construction is still ongoing.
The president urged residents to refrain from actions detrimental to drainage systems, such as dumping debris and filling up reserves.
You have a lot of irresponsibility from residents themselves. This, you know, development, everybody has to be involved, everybody has to take responsibility. You can't be dumping old cars in a drain. You can't be filling up reserves. You can't be destroying reserves. You can't be building huge concrete bridges across the drain.
President Ali also called on community leaders to adopt a more proactive approach in addressing these issues. Venezuela has intensified its claim to two-thirds of Guyana's territory, and President Dr. Mohamed Irfan Ali has reiterated that his government is working with international allies to maintain stability in the Western Hemisphere.
Speaking in an interview with CNN, the head of state assured that every precautionary measure is being taken to ensure the safety of Guyanese.
We are engaging State Department, we are engaging the White House, the President Lula and myself had conversations, so CELAC, CARICOM, Commonwealth and the OAS, they're all engaged on this matter so that they can weigh in in ensuring that Venezuela does not act in a reckless or adventurous manner.
Speaking with the CBS News on the Guyana-Venezuela border controversy, President Ali reaffirmed Guyana's commitment for a peaceful resolve.
Because our first line of defense is diplomacy. Mm-hmm. And we've been reaching out to leaders. The U.S. Is a strong support of Guyana. And also countries, India, we have raised this with India. We have even raised this with Cuba, countries that have a very close relationship with Venezuela, so that they can encourage Venezuela to do what is right and to ensure that they do not act in a reckless or adventurous manner that can disrupt the peace within the zone.
On Wednesday, President Ali spoke with France 24, the French state-owned international news television network.
We are working with our partners. We are working with the United States, the State Department. We are working with the Department of Defense to collaborate and to ensure that Guyana is not caught off guard and that we are prepared. Though our primary objective is to ensure that peace prevail in this zone, to ensure that we encourage Venezuela to act in a manner that is befitting of a country that has respect for the rule of law and has respect for international order.
During a live broadcast late Tuesday evening, President Ali said the measures are in blatant disregard of the order given by the International Court of Justice, ICJ, on December 1st, 2023.
I have tonight spoken to the Secretary General of the United Nations and several leaders, alerting them of these dangerous developments and the desperate actions of President Maduro that fly in the face of international law and constitute a grave threat to international peace and security. Also, Guyana will tomorrow bring this matter to the United Nations Security Council for appropriate action to be taken by that body.
In the midst of increasing tensions with Venezuela over the ongoing border controversy, President Ali told the Qatari television network Al Jazeera on Wednesday evening that Guyana is prepared to defend its territory should tensions elevate to an extreme level.
Why should we be in a position to defend what is ours? We went to the ICE, the United Nations Security Council, this morning, and to alert the Security Council. We have called upon all our regional partners. CARICOM, Commonwealth, and the OAS have all issued very strong statements. We are working with our allies in a precautionary manner, to ensure that we keep our people safe and ensure the territorial integrity and sovereignty of Guyana.
President Irfan Ali met with the top Caribbean Examination Council CXC performers from across the region at State House on Wednesday.
During the meeting, President Ali congratulated the students for their exceptional work, which he said not only makes their families, friends, and country proud, but the entire Caribbean region. On Friday afternoon, President Ali bid farewell to the late retired Justice Prem Prasad. The president hailed Justice Prasad as an outstanding public servant who was a rare gem that contributed selflessly in service to his country. Later that evening, the head of state spent 3 hours in caucus with CARICOM heads of state to update and discuss the current situation on the Venezuela-Guyana controversy. CARICOM firmly supports Guyana in pursuance of the resolution of its border controversy with Venezuela through the process of the ICJ. Further, CARICOM urges Venezuela to respect the conservatory measures determined by the ICJ in its recent ruling until a final resolution.
This was the President's Diary, where we took a look at His Excellency Dr. Mohamed Irfan Ali's week of activities. Thank you for watching, and you join us again next time.